Welcome back to my channel. So for today's video, I'm going to be recreating this look that I have on right now. I caught inspiration from one of my favorite YouTubers here on YouTube. Her name is I Love Seta E. She is so amazing. She is just such an amazing makeup artist and I love her so much, and she is gorgeous and I just love her looks. So if you guys haven't checked her out, go check her out. But she posted a video for Valentine's Day. It was a Valentine's Day tutorial and I loved what she did with a shimmery cut crease and this maroon pinky type mauve-y eyeshadow. And I loved it so much. So a lot of this look has inspiration from her video. So make sure you guys go check her out, and her video is down below. She is an amazing makeup artist and beauty guru, and oh, she's just fantastic. I think this look would be so amazing for a prom look. If you guys are going to prom, this would be such a cute look to wear with any gown that you guys are wearing. Festival season is coming up, so this would be perfect for Coachella or Ultra or any of the festivals that you guys are going to. I'm not a very big festival person, but yeah, isn't it? Lollapalooza, Bonnaroo, you know, all those. This would be a great makeup look for festivals. It's a lot of long wear products, so this would last you throughout the entire day. Before we go, make sure you guys like this video and also hit that subscribe button and join the fam if you haven't already. If you guys would like to learn how to get this look, then just keep watching. So my eyebrows are done and already filled in. I do my eyebrows in like every tutorial for you guys, so if you guys wanna see how I do my eyebrows, just go check out any of my other videos on my channel. I do my whole eyebrow routine for you guys. But since we are finished with that, I'm gonna move on to hydration and prepping and priming the skin. I'm going to be using the Arctic Berry Cocktail Brightening Hydra Oil. This is actually my first time using this product. I heard it's really, really good. On the face. Move that all in. My face has been very dry lately because it is getting a little bit hotter now in California. The cold is kind of going away, moving into festival season or spring. Hydrating the face, it's so important to do this, especially if you're gonna wear a look all day. You really wanna hydrate your face. To wake up the face, I'm going to be using the Too Faced Festival Refresh Mystical Effects Setting and Refreshing Spray. Wow. I'm just gonna spray that all over. Feel awake, feel woke. Stay woke, friends. So now to prime the face, I'm going to be using the L'Oreal Paris True Match Lumi Liquid Glow Illuminator Prime and Highlight. And I'm actually gonna mix it with the Too Faced Proactive Nourishing Hangover Face Primer, which is my go-to everyday primer for probably for the rest of my life, because it's just so amazing. It really makes your makeup look super smooth and is just awesome. We're gonna move straight into eyes. So I'm gonna be using the Born This Way Naturally Radiant Concealer. This is probably one of my favorite concealers that I have used. We're just gonna prime the eyelids with this. This is like a daily primer that I use on my lids. It's just so great. Can't remember the last eyelid primer that I used. I really don't remember. I'm just using this dense stippling brush to kind of blend it all out. You may not think that this part of the eye is important, but let me tell you, friends, it really is. Just think of it as your face primer. You kind of need that base and prep before you put on the magic. You really want to get it to where there's no harsh lines. So really just dab and get everywhere you can. And it's concealer anyways, so if it gets under the eye or around the eye at all, that is no problem. So now I'm going to be using the Too Faced Natural Face Palette. This is Too Faced New Collection, and I just got it. They just sent it to me, and it's amazing. I love it so far. So I'm going to be using the Pink Sand color in the face palette for the transition color. This is going to be one of our main colors in this look. When I put a color in my crease, I always like to also pull the color in to my lid as well as blend it out to make that wing effect. Now I'm gonna use more of a dense flat brush to move that color along the whole entire crease and make a more defined line across for the cut crease. Do the same thing to the other eye. And you really want to make sure this crease line all the way across is defined, because we are going to be doing a cut crease, so we really need to make sure that the hollowness of the eye is there for sure. So now I'm going to be using the color Mars in the Makeup Geek Manny MUA collab palette. So this color is going to create a little bit of a darker effect on the eye, so we're just going to do it in that same place. This is all about really blending and packing it in, this whole look. And we're just gonna do the same thing with the flat brush, create that line, the crease line across the whole eyelid. Same thing to the other eye. Really pack it into your eyelid and the crease. That is really the technique that you should be using throughout this whole look. If you do blending the whole entire time, like sweeps, you may get it in areas that you don't want to get it in. So really just focus on dabbing and patting instead of sweeping. Do some sweeps to kind of blend the edges out so they're not harsh, but this darker color, you really want to just pat instead of sweeping. Really just carve in that crease. So we are done with the crease. We're done. Praise the Lord. Woo-hoo. Now moving on to a very, very, very important part of the eyelid. It is probably the most important part of this look. It's that pop. It is the metallic looking cut crease that we are going to be creating. I'm gonna be using the Bia Bombshell Cosmetics eye paint in Make It Rain. So we really wanna be careful on this. If you guys mess up, don't worry, don't get discouraged. It is a very hard skill to master. I literally just mastered it and I'm really still even trying to perfect it. So we're gonna see how this goes. I've had coffee today, so my hands are a little shaky, but we're gonna see how this rides. I'm gonna pray to the makeup gods to help me get through this. The brush I'm using is the Smashbox number 6 brush. It's a very small, amazing little brush. It is great for those hard to reach places and especially for cut creases. It's great. Okay, I'm like kind of nervous to do this. This is only like my third time doing this, so. Layo, layo. Layo, layo. You really want to know where your crease is in this, because if you get it above the crease, when you blink, the shadow will come down and it will be everywhere, and it's kind of a disaster. I'm gonna use this sky to kind of go over a little bit of paint. I'm gonna go back in with the darker maroon color Mars from the Manny MUA palette and just pack that on the outer crease to kind of cover up where the shimmer ends. We want that nice fade. So I'm gonna go in like over. Moving on to the other eye. Now I'm just gonna clean up the under eye here and then create that nice line. For this look, I'm not gonna do a winged out eyeliner. I'm just gonna be doing a small line of eyeliner on the lash line. I don't wanna do a winged eye just because it's such a dramatic look, and I don't want it to take away from the glitter and shimmeriness of the inner corner. So I am just going to fill the gap between the lash line. I just always like doing that because it's just a good thing. This does not have to be a super perfect line whatsoever. You're barely gonna see it, but I just feel like it helps it that much. Now I'm gonna be using my fave, the Better Than Sex Mascara. For eyelashes, I'm going to be using the Huda Beauty lashes in Scarlet. So now for foundation, I'm going to be using the Giorgio Armani Luminous Silk Foundation. I'm going to be mixing this foundation with the Dermablend Professional Flawless Creator Multi-Use Liquid Pigments Foundation. This is a little bit of a lighter color because I am not as tan as I normally am, so I'm just mixing these two so it goes and blends better with my skin tone. I just tried out this foundation and it's probably one of my favorite foundations I've ever used. It goes on your skin so smooth and it lasts throughout the whole entire day. I've gone through sweat and tears with this foundation and it hasn't left any streaks or creases or anything throughout the day without even touching it up throughout the day. I swear this foundation is just everything. Look at how smooth it is and it's not even fully blended yet. Like, that's insane. If I am going to splurge on anything in makeup, it is always foundation, because I believe that foundation is like everything. I think it's one of the most important parts of makeup when creating a good makeup look, just because it sets the tone for the entire face. There's different tones and undertones of foundations. If you get the slightest wrong color of foundation, it's like your whole makeup look is not okay. It's like, it's terrible. I splurge on my foundation because I don't want to look too yellow. I don't want to look too white. I don't want to look too orange because trust me, girl, I wouldn't be saying this if I didn't come from experience. I have looked like an orange and I have looked like a ghost, so. Now for concealer, I'm gonna be using the Maybelline New York Concealer in the shade Sand Sable. Such a good concealer. I'm just gonna put this all underneath to brighten up the under eyes. I need to get some more of this. So now that we have concealer on, we are going to move on to bronzer. Now, if you watch my videos, you guys know I love bronzing and anything that makes me look more tan, you know, love being tan. I'm gonna be using a new bronzer that I just tried out. It is the Too Faced Milk Chocolate Soleil Longwear Matte Bronzer. A very light bronze to start out with, to get a base going. I'm also using the Morphe 1581 brush. It's like a very nice contouring brush that I love using. I'm just gonna put this everywhere where I would put a normal contour. Oh my gosh, it tastes like chocolate. So now to warm up the face even more and to chisel my face out a little bit, I'm going to be using the Too Faced Sun Bunny Radiant Duo Toned Bronzer. This is also from their new Natural Collection. What I love about this bronzer is that it's not just a tan brown color. It also has a hint of pink in it, light pink. So it's more of a natural rosiness, and then it also has that shimmer, so it's very glowy. What I'm gonna do now is take some translucent powder and bake. You know, I love my baking. I love going in this area of the cheeks because that is where I get my most oily. I find a lot of people get super oily there. So while I'm baking, I'm going to start on my lower lash line. And I'm also gonna do this while I'm baking because if any fallout comes down, I'm gonna dust it off anyways with the bake. I'm gonna go back in with the Mars color that we used for the outer corners. And I'm just gonna use it halfway across the lower lash line. We are done with this look. Oh, girl, you better. Yes, I am so obsessed with this look. I am so happy with how this came out. This look was very challenging for me. I don't really do a lot of cut creases that often, but today I wanted to challenge myself. I have been wanting to try it for so long. I've never filmed it for you guys. I've tried it before without a camera, and it's gone in a total disaster. This look is not only for prom. This can be for a night out or a date, or even if you just wanna throw on some pretty makeup, this would be a perfect look for you. Thank you to I Love Seta E for inspiring me to create this look. She is such an amazing YouTuber and I just love her so much. And I hope one day I can meet her because she is just so amazing. I love all of her makeup looks. She is just awesome. So I'm gonna put her link down below to the inspiration video that I had for this look. She does amazing eye looks and makeup in general. So make sure you guys go to her videos and subscribe to her channel because she is so amazing and I love her. This is not only just a prom look, this is for like a night out out, or if you just want to throw on some makeup one night, play around and experiment, you should definitely try this look. Also, festival season is coming up, so this would be a great look for festival season. It's very glowy, very highlighted, very shimmery, and I think that that is all festival season vibes. So this would be great for that if you're going to any festivals like Coachella or Ultra or anything like that. I'm just so proud of myself. I love this look. Before we go, make sure you guys like this video and also hit that subscribe button and join the fam if you haven't already. What other tutorials do you guys want to see in the future? I am planning a bunch of videos and I want to know what tutorials you want to see. If you want to see more makeup tutorials, more lookbooks, etc., just comment down below what you guys want to see and I'm so down to film them for you. I need your help, so make sure you comment. Subscribe once again. I love you guys so much. All the products that I use are listed down below in the description, so make sure you guys go check that out if you want to order some of the stuff. And I will see you guys next week. Bye!